This is episode 34 of the BioBalance Healthcast. I'm Dr. Kathy Maupin.
And I'm Brett Newcomb. And today we're talking about the symptoms of hormone imbalance. So, you know, we've talked about these things before. And one of the things that strikes me is how much I am learning. I've been doing family and individual therapy for 30 years. And I do a lot of marriage counseling and a lot of premarital counseling. And I have not known the things that I have needed to know. I keep remembering there was a lady that I saw probably the first or second year that I was doing therapy that came to me. She had had a brain tumor in surgery. And then afterwards had lost all sexual the ability to experience pleasure and satisfaction. She still wanted to have sex because she wanted to maintain a relationship. And she had been to a lot of places saying, can you help me? And I wish I knew then what I know now. I feel so badly about, you know, whatever happened with her. I finally said, after I got a picture of what was going on with her, I said, you know, you need to go to a specialist and let me send you to Masters and Johnson's. So I'm hopeful that they were able to help her. But
with head injuries...
With head injuries, I don't know that it's absolutely relevant to hormones, but I don't know that it wasn't. You know?
It actually is, and it's a big subject now.
Yeah.
Head injuries, auto accidents, head injuries from falls, things like that, those are things that cause a disturbance in the hypothalamus. And the hypothalamus is deep in our brains. And if it's damaged, then everything that comes from the hypothalamus, everything to the pituitary, everything from the pituitary to all of our glands are disrupted. So we see people who have low growth hormone, low testosterone, low estrogen, low prolactin, low oxytocin. So they end up having their whole lives changed. I mean, they're different people because all of those hormones change their personalities and their emotions, especially their sex lives. I mean, that is so intricate and takes so many hormones to come through successfully.
Anytime you mess with the structure of the brain and the neurotransmitter processes in the brain, one of the side effects of that can be, or automatically is, change in mood and personality and sexual function.
That's right. That's right. And there's kind of like a lot of other things that go along with it. Frontal lobotomy has a lot to do with other things. Has to do with emotions more than anything else. And people who have frontal lobotomies, I don't know that they do those anymore. Thankfully, I'm not sure that that's a current treatment. But people who have that have lost their emotions. They don't feel the same emotions, or they feel very intense emotions. So in that way, I'm not an expert in that.
No, I think that they've made those more precise, and now they do what's called a laser cingulotomy for treatment of excessive and extreme OCD. But that's just finding a very narrow spectrum of cells and hitting them with a laser. So they don't sever the frontal lobe the way they do. At least I don't think they do. Maybe somebody out there can tell us.
But today we're talking about the symptoms of hormone imbalance, and they're varied. There's symptoms from testosterone lack. There are symptoms from estrogen lack and also progesterone lack.
Okay.
So we have a list of symptoms. We give people a questionnaire when they come in to see me, and they usually fill it out online or they fill it out in my office. So in that questionnaire, we always have loss of libido, but we also have memory loss, migraines, depression, anxiety, feeling cold all the time because testosterone makes you warm, losing your self-esteem because testosterone is the hormone of self-esteem. Okay, well, maybe you just have too much. A lot of my patients say they lose muscle mass and they lose strength and stamina, and that's one of the first things that they come in for. But all of that is secondary to testosterone lack. So that's one list.
Right. And in the conversations that we have had, you have always consistently said that the domino that starts that aging, deterioration, change process is testosterone. And when the testosterone balances begin to decline, then there's evidence of menopause and andropause, and all of these other things come as a result.
So testosterone happens first?
Yes.
And these symptoms are generally the first symptoms that patients come in with. If they're younger, these are the only symptoms they have. Generally, as they come in older age, they've been suffering through testosterone loss, then progesterone loss for women, and finally estrogen loss. And that's usually 10 years after the testosterone is gone. But progesterone loss is PMS. And some people have that their whole lives. Some people do not make good progesterone because they don't ovulate well. But progesterone also, I mean, it can give you the irritability, just chronic irritability, mm-hmm. chronic inability to sleep, which also testosterone, lack of testosterone impairs sleep. But progesterone impairs falling asleep. Testosterone impairs
staying
asleep.
Staying asleep. All right. So the system, the hormone system, is meant to be a self-correcting, balancing system. And when we're young and the system works, then we don't have these issues. Mm-hmm. And historically, medicine has looked at the aging process and said, well, you know, it comes to all of us and that's what's happening.
Too bad. And you're getting old. That's it.
What the research is showing, what you have found mm-hmm. in 9 years of doing this as a specialty, mm-hmm. is that much of that doesn't have to be automatic and doesn't have to be inevitable, because mm-hmm. you can replace those hormones and restore the balance. And mm-hmm. and one of the ways that I try to understand things is by analogy, and I was asking Kathy about analogies that would be apt that might help other people who don't have science or technical backgrounds understand what we're talking about. And we were talking about the analogy of the lithium batteries versus the nickel cadmium batteries. If you used to have nickel cadmium rechargeable batteries.
This is a guy picture story.
You used to have these rechargeable batteries, but over a period of time, they would develop memory and their rechargeability would decline. Mm-hmm. And that's sort of what happens with the balancing structure of the natural hormone system, is that as you age, the ability to recharge that battery and make you have high energy, positive libido, good mm-hmm. self-esteem, lack of depression, all of those things, declines.
The batteries in your brain, though. Most people think the batteries in your ovary, or the and testicles, the batteries in your brain. And that's the part that doesn't recharge very well if the hormones aren't available. The interesting fact is the brain changes happen first. They make the hormones mm-hmm. decrease, and then that in turn makes the brain changes worse. So when you stop that cycle, then we get to see all of these symptoms halt, and patients go backwards. They don't go, they're not 20 again, they don't look like they were 20 again, but they look a lot younger, they look healthier, and they are healthier.
They're more vibrant and more
alive. And there's more blood flow to their face.
And they report that they
feel that. Yeah, they do. They say, I'm mm-hmm. back.
Yeah.
And what they mean is, I'm back to healthy, young level, and that's what we're looking for. But in this, the symptoms that we go through really mm-hmm. have a purpose. We have to look through. The symptoms are the only thing we see, because we don't know exactly what's going on in the hypothalamus. It's hard to test. So we look at the symptoms from the patient's perspective. They can come in and know which hormone's lacking mm-hmm. because that first group of symptoms is testosterone. The second group is progesterone, and not until we lose our estrogen.
So let's break that out for the audience. Which ones are testosterone? We have a list here.
Yeah, we'll show a list here.
Yes.
So that you can see
there'll be a slide.
But libido and memory depend on testosterone. And lots of times people come in, besides libido, that's obvious, mm-hmm. but they come in and say, my memory's gone, I'm getting Alzheimer's, what's wrong with me? And we're gonna talk about that next week or the week after about mm-hmm. how testosterone affects the memory, but it's true. It affects the neurotransmitters in the brain. Mm-hmm. So that's one of the testosterone problems. Then strength, muscle mass, joint aches, damage to knees and hips mm-hmm. because of lack of synovial fluid, those are all testosterone issues.
And obesity.
Yeah, and obesity, because weight gain occurs. Mm-hmm. When we lose our testosterone, we get more belly fat, we lose our lean body mass, no matter what we do. It's just very hard to make muscle without testosterone.
Do clients really come in and say, you know, I'm experiencing a loss of libido?
They say my marriage is in trouble, and it's because I don't find my husband sexually attractive. I love him, but I don't find him sexually attractive.
Or I'm not able to be responsive. I'm too dry. It's painful.
Now, that's usually older women, and that's mm-hmm. usually from estrogen. That's a lack of estrogen.
Okay.
So that's the last change, is really the dryness.
All right.
Believe it or not, OBs are taught that's
so
the first change.
But
it's really the last change, because estrogen, lack of estrogen, is what causes dryness. So the first problem is libido and sex drive and sex fantasies, and that women just say they don't feel like themselves.
I've had a lot of women tell me they don't have fantasies. That now, whether they're lying and not
maybe they don't know what they are.
Maybe they don't know what they are. But, because I will ask them, do you fantasize? Do you get yourself mentally excited? You know, he's coming home today. We're going to do something tonight. Mm-hmm. That lead-in, that mental mindset is really, really important. And it's especially really important when the systems begin to slow down and deteriorate, because you need more lead time and more prep time.
Right, but I don't think, you know, women have been taught, our generation and the generation before us, maybe not the next generation, have been taught that that's a bad thing to do. You shouldn't be thinking about, even if it's your husband, you shouldn't be thinking about those things. You should take them out of your mind. So I think that probably women are trained not to think about that.
Yeah.
So in any case, isn't it sad? I mean,
it is.
You guys are taught.
Well, it's sad.
It's great.
Oh, yeah. We're taught. Yeah. Every 7 seconds. I mean, adolescent males, I used to teach high school and junior high, and we were taught, you know, every 7 seconds they have a sexual thought.
But
girls obviously don't do that.
No.
Or they.
Well, they may do that, but they can't. They don't admit it. They don't even own it themselves. They don't think, ooh, that was a fantasy.
Yeah.
That's not something they allow themselves. Now, maybe the next generation will be better and healthier that way. But some of the other things that my patients come in and say is they have dry eyes. They can't wear their contacts anymore. They have...
So it's whole body lubrication.
All body lubrication.
Yeah, the fluid systems.
Or they're dizzy and they're off balance.
Yeah.
And that I didn't expect that. I had to go really research it. Mm-hmm. But so many people came in with lack of libido. We gave them testosterone and they said, I'm not dizzy anymore. I mean, I don't have that inner ear problem. So that is one of the things that we see is we found so many things get better from just replacing testosterone. Those are the symptoms for testosterone. Now, progesterone, if you remember, most women start getting funny periods, weird bleeding in our 40s. And that has to do with loss of progesterone. Progesterone just doesn't happen every month. We usually make it from day 14 through 28. And that's why when we don't make it, we have PMS between 14 and 28. And we start acting crazy. That's not us, and we have no control over it. We get irritable, we get angry, we eat everything in sight, chocolate.
But all of that
is progesterone.
Regulated by chemicals and the things that they do, like stimulating the hair follicles to release the egg, stimulating...
The hair follicles, the ovarian follicles, but that's okay.
Follicle, I had that right.
Yeah.
It's not, it's a...
That's...
But it's
that's a beautiful system,
and chemically balanced,
right? And it comes from the brain, and then the system stimulates itself through the pituitary to the ovary, and from the ovary back to the pituitary, and you should have this nice, normal process of estrogen increasing, testosterone increasing, peaking on day 14, and then the egg has already ovulated on day 14. Then where the egg came from, that's the corpus luteum, and it makes progesterone. Progesterone only comes from two places, the corpus luteum and the placenta in a pregnancy. So those are the that's the hormone that makes us calm, sleep better, not irritated. And
if that gets out of balance, then you get irritable, you get moody, you get upset easily.
Some people call it estrogen dominance, but in fact, it is it's just progesterone lack. We have more estrogen and we don't have any progesterone to balance it because they should be in balance. And they are until we're in our 40s.
Okay.
So I think we should go on to estrogen.
Right.
And we may have to do that next week.
Okay, we can talk about that. Well, I want to talk about that. We need to talk about estrogen. We also need to talk about thyroid again
as
we list these symptoms. But I want to talk about the impact that occurs in relationships. Quite frequently, I will have people come in and say, you know, my relationship is in trouble, my marriage is in trouble, and they'll list a lot of these symptoms. And I wonder, there are seven in particular off of this list that I have heard as explanations for marital problems. And in the past, would approach them strictly from a psychological or emotional perspective and not consider the physiological issues. And now I am learning from working with you that we have to check those things out, and it's cost efficient to check them out first.
That's true. It is. And by taking this questionnaire that we have on our website, then most of the patients can see if they may be hormonal. The only way you can know for sure is get blood tests and then have them treated and see if you get better.
Okay, so we will continue this conversation in our next podcast. And if you have questions or comments about anything that we've mentioned so far, you can reach us at podcast@balancehealth.com. And you can also read my blog at brettnewcomb.com.
And if you'd like to know more about BioBalance Health or bioidentical hormones, visit our website, biobalancehealth.com, or call 314-993-0963.